that's what I was going to ask you. I was going to ask you if you could start off by, like, because you went from having a what you thought was a business, meaning you thought you had a business. Someone tells you, hey, look, if you continue it running like this, you're going to be out of business in 6 months. Would you mind sharing with us, like, what are some of the things that you learned along the way, and maybe like some of the things that he said you should implement that were game changers? Because I imagine, like you, there's a lot of people in the same shoe that think that they actually have a business. But the reality is, A, the moment they stop working, the business stops. Two, they're doing a lot of the work themselves versus delegating a lot of it. So what systems did you have to implement in order to get to the point where you exited successfully?
That's a great question. So the first thing I'll tell you is one of the things that one of our, and I have been mentored and coached by many, many different people as I've scaled different people. And one of the people that was my mentor, he said, Steve, he said, can you walk away from your business for a day and have it keep running? And I thought, yeah, I could probably do a day. He goes, how about a month? And I'm like, no way. He goes, how about 6 months? I'm like, no way. He goes, well, then you don't have a business. You own a job.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with having a job, but let's call it what it is. Let's not mince words. Let's know our definitions. A business is a commercial profitable enterprise that runs without you. I didn't have any of those pieces. It was profitable, but it was profitable because I worked. And when I stopped working, the profit, and I wasn't counting my time. I wasn't allocating money towards my time. So yes, I was making money, but was it profitable? Depends on what I value my time at, you know? And so it really made us realize that businesses run under the same chassis, right? So when you look at a business, you have marketing, which makes the phone ring.
Yeah.
Sales answers the phone and they make the conversion. Operations makes it work. And accounting makes sure that your bills are paid. So you've got four pieces to a business. Now, we were very fortunate in the sense that me and my business partner, we were very, very opposite. I was the visionary. He was the integrator. So I was sales and marketing. He was operations. And so because we had that distinctive difference, we were a great team. And we learned over time how to really stay in our lanes. And we really learned to play to our strengths and delegate our weaknesses. And so the thing that I have learned is that a business is a something that is a repetitious task done over and over again to perfection that you're getting remunerated and you're monetizing. It's all a business is. You do it over and over again. Business is supposed to be boring. A lot of people in real estate and other things, they think it should be this craziness going on. The challenge is when it's crazy, you're in chaos. And when you're in chaos, you're not in control. And when you're not in control, you're not making money. So many, many people in business, and we were these people, I'm not saying anything that we didn't personally do. Many, many people are in reactive mode. They're constantly reacting. They're putting out fires. And one of my mentors, he owned 11 businesses. And one day we were at his 30,000 square foot house and I'm having lunch with him. And I'm like, man, how do you do this? I'm like, I don't understand. He worked Tuesdays and Thursdays. He worked 2 days a week with 11 businesses. And I'm thinking, I can't even freaking hold one down. And you got 11. I'm like, how do you do this? And how do you do it 2 days a week? And he goes, you know what it is, Steve? He goes, I'll tell you the answer. He goes, it's one word. And I'm like, okay, you know, I'm pins and needles. I got a pen and paper out. I'm ready to ask him. And he goes, no. And I'm like, no what? And he's like, that's the word. I'm like, I don't, like, you're speaking French to me. Like, he goes, you have to say no. And I'm like, what do you mean? He goes, it's not a matter of saying yes to everything. It's a matter of saying no to everything and saying yes to just the important things. We all know, like, the book, The One Thing and everything. Yeah. And I said, you know, his name was Brad Sugars, owns a Action Coach International. And I said, you know, Brad, I said, that's easy for you to say because you own 11 businesses. You're this mega multimillionaire. And he said, you know what, Steve? He said, I was never this way until I learned to say no. And he goes, that's why your phone has rang 12 times sitting here and mine hasn't rang once because people know not to call me. And stuff still gets done, but it doesn't get done by me. And that was a big turning point for me when you're asking, like, what, you know, the challenges people have in businesses. And again, like, you know, I coach people, mentor people. And the biggest challenges is everyone is reactionary. And, you know, we all have 24 hours in a day. How we use them is the key. And so many people use them incorrectly and they use them reactively. And, you know, when we had property managers in our business, we'd ask them, like, I'm busy. Okay, well, what do you do all day? I don't know. I'm just putting out fires. Okay, well, specifically, what are you doing? I don't know. It's like, well, you're doing something. And it's because you're reactionary. And so one of the things that we learned, I mean, look, when you're in real estate and you own a property management company, need to say we are the trash men of real estate. Nobody liked us, but they needed us. You know, we were the ones that collected rent, dealt with maintenance issues. And it's a necessity to have a professional property management company, in my opinion, if you want to scale and run it as a business, at least. And so what I realized was so many people are reactionary because they don't dictate their day. Yeah. They're not proactive. And so one of the things that we realized in running our business is we said, okay, business is all about relationships and business is all about communication. It's not four walls and a roof. It's the business model and the relationships that's running inside of the four walls and the roof. So we say, okay, there's always a lack of trust with property management companies because they're always reactionary. Owner calls, owner's pissed off, tenant calls, tenant's pissed off. Same thing in any piece of any real estate transaction. So the one thing that we learned that, I'll give you a nugget on is how do you go upstream of that challenge and make that phone call never have to happen? And so we're always like, we'd always ask, okay, why are they calling? They're calling because they have a maintenance issue on their property. Okay, how can we get to them first and let them know the problem is taken care of, not to make these ping pong emails and phone calls going back and forth? Because you're losing seconds, which is minutes, which is hours. And when you're managing 1,000 properties, you have a whole staff employee just dealing with ping pong things that if you just addressed it ahead of time, we could save a whole employee of staff and have them doing something more productive.